This is the Carburetor, beginning your YouTube day with a friendly voice. We're going to be listening to a Rush song today from that radio right over there. One of their big hits called Spirit of Radio. Now, a lot of music reaction videos are people listening to a song for the first time, and that's cool and all. But I think we should also get reactions from people who've heard the song many times, are familiar with it. And with Rush songs especially, it takes time to get accustomed to it, used to it, and then get to like it. I've liked this song for 40 years, and I still like it just as much. And I've been reading that there's more to this song than meets the ear. And when I'm listening to Rush, I'm not really analyzing it. But we're going to do that today. And we're going to get the help of this video. Rush finally made an official video for the song 40 years after they wrote the song. It was made a year and a half ago. You see, back in 1979, that was about 2 years away from when the music video era started. Here's a comment that says, again, Rush delivers. The band never disappoints. Unfortunately, I just found out I can't show too much of this video because videos are still copyrighted. I found that out when I tried to upload this. Well, I'm going to re-edit and make this work. And look at these reaction videos. This is a fun video to watch here. These are two of my favorites. They're pretty legit. After my last video where I reacted to Van Halen, I watched their video reacting to the same song, and at least one of them didn't care for it much. And it just wasn't his thing, and he acknowledged that. And look up here, where it says, that intro. Yes, before we go on any further, let's hear that intro. There's no intro like this one. This is really kick-ass, really original, and there's not really a beat to it. They go on and on without a beat. It's just genius. Let's start it. That just never gets old. See, I don't know why they point out Italy here. What's this? We shouldn't overlook this stuff. Rush is always trying to say something. Some guy I don't know. He's got some equipment there. I figure it's radio equipment. Yeah, I wanted to point out, this song is about radio and the experience of listening to the radio. And remember, this is back 40 years ago. Radio was just huge back then. That's like today's internet, you know. People always had their radios there. Turn it on at the beginning of the day, like we do with our computers now. The band is Canadian. And see, these are radio antennas. I think I'll be doing a lot of Gen explaining in this video. I just made that word up. This is how radio used to work. Well, no, you don't see these anymore, do you? They send out a radio signal. Let's just get into the first lyrics here. Oh yeah, a lot going on here. There's so much to analyze. Here is... Well, this is interesting. This would be a disc jockey at a radio station. I would have never noticed this if I wasn't making this video. That guy looks like Art Bell. Who, before he did his conspiracy alien radio show in the 90s, back in the 70s, he was a rock and pop music disc jockey. That could be him. That's interesting. Get there. There's a boombox. And then there, see, that's, they just switched there. Some people will not notice that, because that is the look of a car radio. That's not the way boomboxes look. I was thinking, that looks like a car radio. And there's the car. And that looks like Neil Peart, the drummer. Let's get to the lyrics here. A friendly voice, that could be the disc jockey or the music. Companion, unobtrusive. I just saw this a few minutes before making this video, and I decided, oh, I definitely want to use this video in this video analyzing the song. I saw pirate radio, and that's very interesting, because I was just watching some show on cable a few weeks ago that had to do with the old days of radio, and they talked about this pirate radio, where they would actually broadcast the radio signals from ships out in the ocean. I forget the reason why they were doing it. Maybe had something to do with laws. And see here, Rush knows about that. So backing up a little bit to that car there it is. I would venture a guess that that is a red Barchetta. For any of my viewers who don't know what that is, you'll be hearing more about it soon. Let's do a little reading on this song on Wikipedia. There's some very unusual things about this song, and there's still stuff that I don't know. It made the top 30 in Canada, and in the US, it reached number 51. I never knew that. It remains one of Rush's best-known songs. The Spirit of Radio features the band experimenting with reggae. Yeah, see, I didn't pick this up, but in the Rush in Rio concert 18 years ago, they really exaggerated the reggae part, people talking about it on the internet. And then it was still years before I realized that part was always reggae. I just never thought about it or analyzed it. Lyrically, the song is a lament on the change of FM radio from freeform to commercial formats during the late 70s. The radio station in their hometown did not abandon freeform, and that is the inspiration for this song. That's all it says here. Well, let's keep going with the song and see what I can figure out for myself. I don't know what's with the flag of Britain. We saw that on the ship, though. Oh, another thing I just thought of. I might as well bring this up. You see these characters dancing, and that reminds me of on a Rush forum 18 years ago. There were people saying that Rush's music is not danceable, and me and some other people took exception to that. We do dance to Rush. It just makes you want to move. And especially that beat right there. That is quintessential Rush right there. Thing the singer is doing with his hands there. He does that in concert, and I was just figured that's to signal to the audience to clap at that part, which the audience does. But here, they're just going out of their way with this hand stuff. It looks like close encounters here. Maybe I'm missing something. That fast guitar that you hear in the opening and one or two other places in the song, that sounds like tapping, which I talked about a little in my last video with Van Halen there, but I don't think it was tapping. And here I found them playing the song live, and here's what he's actually doing. I just don't know what he's doing there, but I'm not a lead guitar player. But what's so great about Alex and Eddie Van Halen isn't just the skill involved, it's how they take the skill and they come up with stuff that just sounds mind-blowing. Certain sounds we just haven't heard before, and that's what Rush does really well. It takes time to get used to this band, but once you do, you are an excited fan for life. Oh, no. it's hard to tell where the chorus and verse are. Lyrics, prizes and endless compromises shatter the illusion of integrity. Good stuff. This part and the other part that they keep switching between are just about the same thing, except it's just played differently. So maybe there's no chorus in this song. That's weird. So that was the second time they played that mellow part, and I noticed there's guitar in this part, but that first time there was only synthesizer. There was progressing in the songs. I was like that. Even the drums. I drummed to Rush, so I noticed that he does the exact same thing. A certain part of the song, he won't do very much, and then he'll keep building and add more in the fills. That's cool stuff. Okay, right here, see, they're doing something a little different here. They're taking that general line, but here, there's no lyrics, and they turned it into 7/8 time instead of 4/4. In every measure, they leave out the last beat, and that makes it really cool, really cool. It's one of the things I like best about Rush. It just really makes it really funky. And then notice this, what happens on the hi-hat the second time around. So anyway, that was the reggae part there. It just seems to stick out more. Well, I've never been really familiar with reggae music. Maybe that's it. And Rush is always doing experimental stuff. Here's the reggae part live in 2002. So time to listen to the end of the song. So at the beginning, we went from good times, all the good stuff about radio, and now near the end, we're talking about salesmen ruining everything. So let's see what happens. With the sound of salesmen. A lot of good stuff in there, in the video and the song. It jams. It doesn't get old. Speaking of old, let's see what these college guys thought. Let's see their reaction to the beginning
They're just too good. They're three guys.
All right, guys.
Said,
need to be done.
Go and dive into it, man. Hold up. That was, that just feels quintessential. Holy.
Back that up. Let's hear it again.
Dude, all that in a 5 minute song. Dude, I teared up. Dude.
That was phenomenal. Dude.
That was five minutes.
That was so good. That might be the best song I've heard on the channel. That's at least a contender. Holy cow. Dude, I got goosebumps.
The talent of these musicians is always through the roof, world class all day.
Dude.
Rush on a different level, but with that said, it comes down with Rush to the songwriting, like to this specific song.
Yeah.
But this song, dude, the songwriting.
And even though it's a hard rock song, they're able to incorporate synthesizer in. Yeah, this was before the synthesizer era, which didn't really pick up till like 4 years later, 1983. I was just watching some of this and looking for something. Here they are playing this song live, and just seeing just a few seconds of this opening, as a Rush fan, just gives me a huge rush. It probably wouldn't give you that same feeling if you're not a fan. That's why you need to be a fan. Because nothing gives me a rush like this band. And this clip right here does it for me. Just have to know the band really well and the song to understand what's so exciting about that. So I read somewhere this song has a bunch of music styles in it besides reggae, and the reason I did that is to show the types of genres on the radio, but I can't seem to find any more. I heard something about the mellow part with the keyboards. You could call that pop, where they go back into the main riff for a second time. The drumming is different. He's just hitting the crash all the time, I guess. And something different with the snare, where he does that double hit. And that changes the feel of the beat, but I'm not sure what kind of style that would be. If any of you know or have any ideas, post it below. I missed something I meant to mention right after the guitar solo. I was just in a zone there, and I forgot. There's so much going on there. I didn't hear the piano in there to remind me to bring it up. Did you hear the piano? So that wraps it up. So thumbs up. Of course, thumbs up. Leave a comment. I want to hear what everybody thinks. And subscribe for more of this kind of stuff.